In this video, I'll explain how we can control a motor wirelessly using a Bluetooth module and an Arduino board. So, the Bluetooth module which we are going to use and which is compatible with the Arduino is the HC05. As you can see, it has 6 pins: state, RXD, TXD, ground, VCC and key. The state and key pins of this module are used to configure the Bluetooth module and change its password, baud rate, name, etc. The RXD pin is connected to the TXD pin of the Arduino, and this pin cannot take more than 3.3 volts. Now, the TXD pin of the Arduino always gives an output of 5 volts. So, to avoid this and only give 3.3 volts, we are going to use a voltage divider network to connect the Arduino board and the Bluetooth module. The TXD pin of the Bluetooth module is connected to the RXD pin of the Arduino board. Now this will transmit information from the Bluetooth module to the Arduino board. The ground and VCC are connected to the ground of Arduino, and VCC is given as 5 volts which can be taken from the Arduino. The app which we are going to use to control the motors is the Arduino BT joystick, which is free and is available on Play Store. So as you can see, it has various buttons and we are going to configure these buttons to control motors. Let us now see the code. So in this program, I have defined variables like motor 1 pin, motor 1 pin 2, enable 1 pin and state. And each of them have been given a value of 765, which is the pin on the Arduino board. The state is only a variable which I am going to use to store. So I have declared motor 1 pin, motor 1 pin 2 and enable 1 pin as output pins. So these are the outputs of which will be taken from the Arduino board and will be given to our motor driver IC. I have kept enable high because I always want to run the motors and I am never going to interrupt them. So that is why enable is always kept high. Serial.begin is used to start the serial monitor, and 9600 is its baud rate. Now this baud rate can be changed in the program and it can be made compatible with your Bluetooth module. If the baud rate of the Bluetooth module is different, then the baud rate here will also change. So that is what I have done in void setup. In void loop, I have checked if the serial monitor is available or not, which is why I have given if serial.available is greater than 0. So if that is the case, only and only if the serial monitor is available, only then it will read the states. Now why I have done this, because the serial monitor only opens when an Arduino board is connected to it. If there is no Arduino board, then it will not take any state variable. It will not take value in the state variable. So the value in the state variable is defined by the buttons which we are going to press in the app. So each button on the app has a unique state value, and each button will send a unique state value to the Arduino board according to which we are going to decide our logic. So if nothing is pressed, the Arduino board will receive a value 0, and if that is what is happening, then we don't want our motor to run. Hence we have given both the both pins of the motor as the same potential, which disables the motor and it will not run the motor. Now we have also taken two more states, which is state 1 and state 2. Now state 1 and state 2 are corresponding to the buttons which are on the app. So you can check in the app which button has which state and what it is going to transmit to the Arduino. According to that, we can configure our motor and we can change the direction of the motor. Once it will go in one direction and the other time it will go in the other direction, as we have given low high and high low consecutively. So now we will see the output of this program. So now we have connected the Arduino, the Bluetooth module and the motor according to our program. The pins from the Arduino, which are 5, 6 and 7, are connected to the enable pin, motor pin 1 and motor pin 2 of the motor driver IC. So the motor driver IC also needs to be powered using 5 volts and ground, which can be taken from the Arduino. The RXD and TXD pins have been connected to the Arduino board, but as I have explained before, the RXD pin, which needs to be connected to the TXD pin of the Arduino, has to be protected because it cannot take more than 3.3 volts. Hence, we have created a voltage divider network which will protect it. The TXD pin of the Bluetooth module has been connected to the RXD pin of the Arduino board. Also, make a note that when you are going to upload the program, you need to disconnect these pins, as the Arduino board will not accept the program if the pins 0 and 1 are connected to something. So while uploading, disconnect these pins, keep them out, upload the program and then connect according to your specifications. So now let us see how we can control the motor using the app. So as I am pressing the down button, it is going in one direction, while when I press the up button, it goes in the other direction. So using these pins and buttons, we can control multiple motors, and that can be done using your program. So that is how we can control motors wirelessly using a Bluetooth module, an Arduino and a motor driver IC for the protection of the motor. And it has various applications, because you can sit at one place and control heavy machinery at other place wirelessly. Thank you.